as you are the chairman of the United Christian Forum, we want to ask a few questions about salvation. And the first question which is like to ask you, what is all about salvation?
See, man is created by God for a specific purpose. The purpose of creation of man is to love him, to serve him, and to be with him for all eternity. The purpose of God's creation, that he may enjoy life with him. Now, something happened in between. God created our first parents, and they were, as the scripture Bible tells us, walking together. That means relationship between God and man was so cordial. But sin came in between, and that relationship was broken. Now, to obtain back that relationship, it was necessary that God sent his Son to obtain us salvation, redeem us from sin. And this is why obtaining that salvation or redeeming us from sin and death is the salvation. To put back that relationship once again, which was broken. And that is the salvation for which Jesus came into this world.
Yes, Your Grace, how to receive your salvation, Your Grace?
Now, walk in the footsteps of Christ is the easiest way of obtaining salvation. When God created man, he created him in his image and likeness. He was as pure, as innocent, as I would say God when he had created. But he lost his innocence through his sin. And now, to get back that salvation, Jesus had to come into this world. He gave us the message of good news, and he called upon us, love God and love our neighbor. He gave us his commandments to walk in his footsteps. As in the Old Testament, the Israelites were brought from Egypt to the promised land, the land which was flowing with milk and honey, which I would say in a way brought them salvation. In the same way, the Lord has given us another land of milk and honey, and that is the church, Mother Church. And to be in the church and to follow Jesus Christ in his footsteps to the way that he has suggested us in the Gospels is the simplest way to obtain salvation. In one word, I would say, as Jesus said, a love of God, a love of our neighbor is summarizing the whole of the commandments of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Your Grace, how to share the good news to others, Your Grace?
Simple, very, very simple. There are thousands of ways you could share the good news to the people around you. The simplest way is live that good news in your life. Simplest way is live that good news and be a witness to the good news. And that's the most powerful way to proclaim the good news. Of course, There are other means. You can go and proclaim by word, teach it through your service, through your acts of charity, through your acts of mercy, through your acts of forgiveness, through many, many other ways. It is not just. The church today tells us the best way is witnessing to your faith, witnessing to your proclamation at home, in your neighborhood, in your workplace, and wherever you are. Even when you are traveling, when you are standing for a, waiting for a bus, waiting for a train, you can proclaim the good news by being really a good disciple of Christ.
Grace, you know, Jesus said in Gospel of John 17 that that unity among the believers, as the chairman of United Christian Forum, what is your thought about this, Grace?
Jesus established one church, one faith, one God, one baptism, we say it. There are no many churches. This one faith. But Jesus also knew that we as individuals, we as human beings, will also have different type of opinions. One day or the other, this kind of different ways of going about will be there. 12 apostles whom the Lord appointed were 12 background. And this is why Jesus prayed that, Father, let there be one as we are one. Now, between the Father and the Son, there is perfect unity. There is perfect unity. And we call them, in everything, they are one. And this is why this unity, God, Jesus prayed for. Now, unfortunately, in the church, this unity came in because of different opinions, different way of going about, and church got divided. Yes, there are today many, many denominations, and still denominations are taking place, and we have seen in this modern world how many divisions are there. But one thing, everyone believes in Jesus Christ. That unity is still there. That everyone says that Jesus is our Savior. That only through Jesus can we can obtain our salvation. But there are some kind of still divisions in the way that we accept Jesus, in the way of our belief, and especially in the way of our sacraments of going about. Now, there's a lot of discussion taking place. Ecumenical dialogues are taking place. And I am sure the Holy Spirit, the unification, through whom the unification comes, one day or the other, through our efforts of praying together, working together, studying together, coming together, I'm sure we will all be one as Jesus prayed for. And this is the day I'm looking for, that one day we will be all one and enjoying that one faith and proclaiming one faith to the world.
Your Grace, the last question is that as we have the Salvation Run on 24th, can you invite all the churches of all the churches in Bangalore to join you in this run, Your Grace?
I am sure they will be very happy to join in the Salvation Run, because now Salvation Run on 24th of March is organized in view of the season of Lent, in view of the Paschal feast and Good Friday. There's Jesus. Now everyone, all the denominations accept this faith that Jesus died for us, that Jesus died on the cross for our salvation. And I'm sure they will be happy to join in this Salvation Run. And I would even look for not only our brethren from other denominations, we can call them, even people of other faith, because there are many, many people who accept Jesus as God, as a prophet, as a savior, and they come to our churches. And everyone wants that salvation, heart of heart. Everyone wants in their own religion salvation. And this is why let us invite even others, people of goodwill, because Jesus came into this world and said, let there be peace among the men of goodwill. So I would happy to have as many as possible of all religions and of all faiths.
Thank you, Guru. Thank you. God bless you.